Francisco Wolka. Welcome into my studio. Thank you so much for your support. And you ask and I listen. You ask me to do some videos about airbrush and you show some tips and some tricks and techniques I use for my cakes. So here we are. I'm going to show you how to make your own booth with a thing to capture all the particles and all the waste of your airbrush so it will not travel anymore all over your kitchen. I'm gonna talk with you a little bit about different compressors and of course the airbrush colors, how to clean your guns, and I'm gonna show you how I make some of my cakes, like a galaxy look like cake, cakes with two colors, look like an aquarium. So we're gonna go through this journey together. I hope you enjoy this video. Please don't forget to subscribe. Leave your comment saying what you wanted to see next. And my daughter is saying to me, please don't forget to push a bell. Apparently there is a bell now that you can press the bell so you get notified first when a new video comes out. Talk about a new video. Next video, I'm going to be in here with my daughter in my studio because she wants to share with you how to make these gorgeous tops to decorate your cake. It was her idea. I love and I'm sure you're gonna love it too. Thank you so much for your support. If you watch the internet, you're gonna see lots and lots of videos about beginner's airbrush. So you should watch it because it's a lot of fun, hours and hours of entertainment. You will learn a lot. So there's a little technique that they do of cutting the paper to create the effect of clouds. So you can cut the paper just straight like that. Different clouds. And I'm telling you, it's hours of fun. By playing with a piece of paper like that, I know it doesn't absorb the same way that a cake would, but at least gives you, a lot of learning how to control your gun, and how much pressure it comes from your gun. Now, one of the first things that you have to learn is how to control the pressure, and you should be able to do dots, big dots, and get bigger and bigger. You should be able to do like a shooting star. You learn to have more control of your gun by releasing the pressure. So you should be able to play, you should be able to do very fine line. Ever play with your airbrush and how much you need to release. How far, the distance that you have to be from your paint. So have a goal. Practicing on a piece of paper. In fact, my daughter is in here behind me right now and she can't wait to have a go. She just told me, "Oh, mommy, just looked like a lot of fun and I wanted to have a go too." So I'm gonna let she play a little bit with that and they're having a lot of fun. So this is another box too, a smaller box, as you can see. I went to Bunnings. I quite like the shape too, the fact that the top is a little bit lower. So what I did is I cut the inside in here of the fan. And of course it doesn't have to be a big fan like that. I got this fan because it was the cheapest. For some reason the smaller fans are more expensive than the big ones. So I cut the inside there. So this is gonna fit perfect to there. Make sure the cable is going out there. So to stay in position and stop it falling off, you can put a little bit of hot glue. So it stays there in position because you don't want it to fall on top of your cake when you're airbrushing. So I just put a little bit of hot glue there. And now we're gonna push. And should fit perfectly in here, as you can see, like that. It will look like that with the cable on the outside, just like that. So then my neighbor was doing renovation in his house and he had a little bit of air conditioned ducting. that thing. So I ask a little piece, because it's the semi-circumference of my fang. But you can put any kind of plastic you have at home. And I'm just going to put a hot glue, but you could use just stick tape. I'm just going to use the hot glue because it's already here with next to me. And I'm just going to go around like that and glue all around my fang so there's no missing air anywhere. So then you get a old bucket, a big bucket, and you put your inductive system or your plastic or whatever you have there on the back. So what's gonna happen is when you airbrush, the fang is gonna push all the color, all the particles, all the waste inside, and it goes straight to the bucket instead to go to your fur detail. As you can see, I turned my fang on and it's pushing, sucking all the air. It comes with one of those, usually the fang. You can just leave it like that, but click there. So it looks more professional. And then you're gonna need a turning table. Put a turning table there so you can put your cakes, so we can start airbrush our cakes. Okay, now that you watched the me making the booth to capture all the particles of the airbrush, I'm gonna talk a little bit about the compressor, the guns, and the airbrush color. I'm not going to go through all the complexities and the techniques because I myself only know the basic, and I use the airbrush to enhance my cakes. But it's a must have. You must have an airbrush. It's gonna change your world. It will change your work. You can add light, shadow, depth to your cake, texture to your cake, shimmer, glitter. You can paint a whole cake in silver, gold. You can cover all your cakes in white. And then on the end of the day, on the next day, you add the colors. You save time, you save money. And it's amazing. What the possibilities is amazing. Everybody asking me, what is the compressor that you use? And at home, at my studio, where I'm doing classes, so I need a very strong, reliable compressor. So I like very much these ones from Workzone. There is 1.6 horsepower in here, so it has enough pressure in here to do my little work with my cakes and hold the load of work, 8 hours airbrushing. It has my gauge in here that I can control the pressure of the airbrush, and with the little watch in here that you can see the pressure. It has moisture catcher. It keeps the pressure in and it stops. So as soon as it builds the pressure in, it stops. So it's a great compressor. Really like that one. The little ones are great too. Don't take me wrong. These little ones, this one especially is from Where Is My Airbrush, is a really good one. It has three modes of speed, and it's light, it's compact, it still has the capture for the moisture. It does perfect job, and when I'm traveling, that's all I use. So I like this very much. There is enough pressure in here to do the work, because we don't need that much pressure for the kind of work we do. Our work is very close and it's very small. When we're talking about pressure, a lot of people ask me, oh, how much pressure? Think about washing your car and how much pressure you need for your hose, the distance you are between your car, the guns. There is many guns on the market right now. You have this gravity feeder that is a little bit bigger, this tank. So for big works, if you are painting a whole cake, that is a really good one. Usually they come with a little cap, and you put a little cap on the top, so if you turn it, the paint doesn't gonna go everywhere. So it's really good. And then you have the little ones. They also have the little cap that you can put on the top, so you can turn it and do small works. I really like this one because you don't waste too much painting on this one. The difference between the guns is you have the dual action and the single action. So dual action, you have to press for the air to come out and then towards you for the color to come out. And a single action, usually the little ones are single action, you just push towards you for the color to come out. For cake decorating, the single action is Just fine, perfect. It does perfect job. When you buy your compressor with the gun, usually comes with a picture of your gun and all the parts inside your gun. It's important to get to know your gun and how to clean and how to maintain clean. So when you have a chance, pull apart, get to know all the pieces, you know, because they are very important. Especially that needle there. This needle is very important, all right? It has to be kept clean. So we have in here the needle cap, the first one that protects the needle. Can you see the needle coming there through the, right there is a needle coming there. So that needle cap protects your needle. So this should always be clean. You should always make sure that everything is clean, that your needle is clean, inside your gun, everything is clean. And the way after you finish cleaning with a lot of water, I always clean with water or with vodka. If I work with shimmers, silvers and gold, sometimes I use the vodka to clean because the alcohol sometimes when we use it for the airbrush, it dries really quick. I know that in some countries you're not allowed to have to use the alcohol, but water is just fine, all right? So after you clean your gun, you put your needle back there, and then you put everything back. I also always push my needle backwards. So you put your gun cap, and then you put your needle cap, and then you can push your needle back in position all the way. And then you put your back cap in here to stop the needle from moving, and then you get the perfect pressure in here. Look, it's moving. This one, this gun in specific, you have another valve in here, another regulator in here on the back, but this is just so you don't overspray your cake. So it's not, you don't have to touch that unless you are doing like you are spraying a whole cake and you don't want it to overspray. So you regulate the maximum that you can push your trigger backwards, and that will stop you from overspraying your cake. So they are really good. The way you hold is always like a pencil, like you holding a pen or a pencil, all right? And they are super light, easy to control. My daughter, if you have a lot of fun with these, so have a go. You're gonna see a couple of videos that I made having a go and showing you a couple of techniques, but internet is full of information. There is really good professional up there, especially on YouTube, showing you step by step, beginners to advanced, how to airbrush it, how to make fire. You should be able to get really good control with stencils. The stencils is very important to get to know and how to mix colors and how to apply a stencil. So it's a really good knowledge to have. I think the most important is use a good quality airbrush, food safe, you know, and you always keep maintain and keep clean your gun, and you will never have a problem. So you can buy a proper cleaning pot, of course, on your cake decorator supply or any art supply, but you know, I just make my own. I got a yogurt pot, and I just made a hole with my drill. You make a hole on the front, couple of holes on the top, so you have the air coming out. I put a little bit of cloth there just to hold so the air doesn't come through the holes on the top. And when you're finishing airbrush, if you have any leftover or when you put the water to clean, you just put it inside and you push your trigger. Everything stays inside, so it's not traveling all over the air or going to your nose. So it's really cheap and easy. You don't have to just spend a fortune on a cleaning pots. You can make your own. You can have a lot of fun. Have a go. Watch some of the videos I did showing you some techniques that is very important to know, and let me know how you go. So this is the magic, and if you are a cake decorator, you know what I'm saying, because black, green, blue, purple, they are travelers, all right? They love to travel. And this is the magic of airbrushing, you know? You have a blanky canvas and you just add the colors that you want to your cake. So my daughter asked for her birthday a black and purple cake. That's all she asked. Double barrel. purple and black. So I'm just gonna add the purple at the top. I usually always start with the light colors and then I move on to the dark colors. So now we're gonna play with the black at the bottom. So by having the rotating table also helps, because then you don't get too much paint just in one point. And you can see the distance I'm always from the cake, you know, around 4 fingers. Because if you go too close, then you get big splash of color there. Not only you are saving money in here because you're not buying fondant already color, but you can get 2 tones in one cake, you know. So this is the magic of airbrush, you know. And with a simple and very cheap boxes that you can create these in any size you need, and it will capture all the particles, all the waste of the color that usually goes to the air. You're still gonna get a little bit inside your nose, but most will go through the back and the fan will capture everything like that. So let's have some more fun, because I have a lot of cakes to airbrush today. So I'm going to show you how to do this really good galaxy painting on your cake. It's super fun, easy. It looks complicated, but it's not, all right? So first you're gonna start with the blue. So you can put as much blue you want in your cake. I just made a line there because I really wanted to make sure that she is really dark at the bottom. This cake is gonna be a Space Invader cake. So you spray a little bit of blue, try to put some splotches of leave some splotches of whitey everywhere. Put a little bit of purple or violet. So I like to put I want a very dark here at the end there, at the bottom. And then you can go. And when you do splats like that, in fact, sometimes I like to hold the airbrush hose. And I like to pump a little bit a couple of times, and when I release, you get a little bit of the splats of the color there. And for a galaxy cake, this is perfect. It's really good. So you can go in round motions, but try to leave some splats of white. So I got the purple little bit everywhere, and now I'm going to get a little bit of black. So remember, I always start with the light colors, and then I work my way out to the darkest color. So I'm going to make really dark at the bottom there. I want really dark. I want a dark on the corners too. You know, both corners I want really dark. And then I'm going to work my way. Splots, if you want to hold the hose, couple of pumps. And then when you release, you get these little splats of black there, right? Very similar, see? So the more you leave it, the better it will look. Then we move on to some contrast colors. So on this, you see I put some splats of yellow there. So you can work your way out. A little bit of pink this time, something different. A splat of pink there. So you could be a yellow like that, or a splat of pink. You can put as much you want, you know. I really love this one from Magic Color that you have all the shiny beads on. So I just made a hole and I just put against my cake and spray inside, and you get the illusion of a star or a planet. For the little stars, I just get a little bit of the white. And look, the toothbrush is the best tool you can have. And I know a lot of people like to use the gloves, the disposable gloves, to put on. But I don't get the same effect and the same contact, so I do have to use my hands. And all you have to do is put the whiting on your toothbrush, and then you splat at the cake. Absolutely incredible the effect you can get with just flicking you know, with your fingers, the more flicking, the more stars you get. Of course, you can get your brush too. You can get your brush, a very thin brush, and you know, if you want, you could make some lines to create the star effect, if you want a star effect. But it's much better if you do this after the airbrush is completely dry, and then you come back and you do a star effect in your cake. But just like that, when it dries, you get a super cool galaxy effect on your cake. So I'm going to keep going, and I do this all four sides and the top. Your airbrush without gloves, because I'm always like that. I cannot get gloves. Solvo is the best. This bar makes a miracle.
Look at that. Smooth as a baby's bottle.